All right, we have a tag team Extreme Rules drag call-out match. Coming from these two gentlemen, Vicious and Delicious, headed to the ring. These two dominant divas are the HWA Tag Team Champions. And they have a lot of moxie behind those pink and purple outfits. And it's raining men out here, ladies and gentlemen, apparently. Let me look up. I don't see any, but yeah. They say it's raining men. I'm going to move the hell out the way. I don't need anything hitting me in the face. These two gentlemen jumping into the ring, ready to do their thing here tonight. And these two gentlemen are getting ready to rumble. Let's see what else is going to happen here in this match. Will we have new tag team champions? We will find out. What kind of action are we going to have here tonight? Let's see what we got. Here comes their opponents. We got straight meat slapping action today. The Drag of Rock coming to the ring, styling and profiling, and they are ready. These two dominant queens coming into the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, I have no clue. No clue who's gonna win this. This is probably going to be an absolute slapdown. And I apologize. I believe I said the titles were on the line. They are not on the line tonight. We will get it started. Team Tornado Tag, Diva Action, the drag of the evening. Delicious, and they're gonna keep pushing forward here. Setting him up. That's going for that spin kick. Booyah! Owen catches a chair. Bringing that table into the ring. But we got a cover. No count. Oh, and someone's getting the fist to the face. A lot of tag team action right now currently. Oh, and the dead's press. The dead's press. And now the team of Drag Rock are taking opportunity after opportunity to beat down their opponent in the ring. Looking up under the ring. Oh, he misses with that chair. Oh, and he runs away. But he catches a choke slam off the ring side area. Oh! Oh, with the bat, but he got reversed. Oh, we're going over to the other side now. Action over there by the ring announcers. And he's getting beat down with that bat. This is absolute mayhem right now. Apropos to the name HWA Mayhem. Oh, running to the corner. Oh! And these gentlemen have been absolutely giving each other the business, and I'm trying to find out which one will be victorious. Oh, he gets him back into the ring. Oh, oh! Through the trash can. Oh, he's going for a cover. What's that one? One count only. And again with the double team. Taking those chances. Slowly, slowly, methodically pulling that arm. And coming back down with the knees. Oh, out the ring. Sling blade. Into a drop kick. Oh, no reversal there. Action inside of the ring and out of the ring. Oh, man, I can't wait for the couple of matches later on. Paul Green facing off against Razor Parker and Victor Venom. Tag teaming against CJ Blade. Don Johnson and Hunter Hawkins in that six-man Extreme Rules match. But we gotta get to this action here. Cover one, two, no. You gotta think there's a lot of animosity between these two tag teams. One trying to be prettier than the other. Who's gonna come out glamorous in this one? Oh, what a shot with that stop sign. Sling blade again into the drop kick once again. Dominance of Divas. Oh, spear! He's going for a cover. Oh, his partner's weary. Three, it's over. Vicious and Delicious will take this one in a huge win. What a match there. I mean, I just so much action going on in that matchup. It was just a beautiful nuance of moves and power. But we're going to go to the next matchup. Coming to the ring, we got Nora Cool. This is another Extreme Rules matchup. Nora Cool coming down. She looks really methodically sound right now. Coming to the ring, ready to get it on. Can she take down Roxanne here? Nora Cool praying to the gods for a victory. And now here comes Roxanne. Roxanne. The girl with the master plan. Conversation with her after this matchup. I mean, this woman is cute. Roxanne is ready. Nora's ready. Let's get it on. And Nora grabs her, taking her over to the ropes. Oh! And that slow choke over the ropes. Well, Nora Cool shot to the gut. Coming back over. Oh, for a quick cover. One, two, no. It's going to take a lot to take down this gorgeous goddess in Roxanne. But she got her in a choke, rear naked choke, and she's getting out. Oh, Dragon Twist Cutter. One, two, no. And these two women are absolutely doing everything that they can to beat the other. Into that arm drag bulldog combination. Oh, and they're going at it. Mano y mano in the ring. Shot for shot. Who's gonna come out on top? Oh, come on, Roxanne. Roxanne has stolen this announcer's heart. You gotta do it, Roxy. Who's gonna come out? They're standing there in the middle of the ring. Oh! Both a blow. They're close. They're close on punching. Mass punching. And Noro takes the advantage and throws her out of the ring. What she's doing now. Oh, she's got something in her hand. She's got a barbed wire bat. She's taking it to Roxy. Oh, the humanity. And she just won't stop. Oh! Roxy back in control. Come on, Roxy. Prove this man to be correct. Into a cover. One count only. And these two divas. Oh, she's flipping her off. Don't flip off my heartthrob. Roxanne in the corner with a reversal. Oh, she's putting her DDT. And she's up top. A big elbow off the top rope. Nora is down. She's up now. Oh, almost got that guitar shot. What are you doing here, Nora Poole? Attacking the knees. Oh, and she told her that something where the sun don't shine. Gotta imagine there's a lot of animosity between these two. And another chokehold. She's got her down. There's no way she can win outside of the ring. She's got to get her inside. Oh, and a kick. Roxanne taking her, throwing her back into the ring. And she's stalking from the outside. Oh, she's got a fluorescent light. Will she be able to? No! Black mask! Going into a cover. One, two, no! What? She almost took down Roxanne there. Nora methodically stalking her. Giving her everything that she's got right now. And she's got a guitar. Oh no! Right to the stomach! And Roxanne is in trouble. And she recovers. She reverses. Come on, Roxy. I'm very biased in this matchup. She's stolen my heart at the beginning. It was love at first sight. She coming up top. Oh, senton bomb from the top rope for cover. One, two, no. That was a little fast count, but I'm not biased. It was pretty on time for me. And Roxanne got her in the submission. Will she tap? Will she give up? No! Nora escapes. Oh, and a fast press into the punches. And here comes Roxanne off the rope. Senton again. One more time. Will she get it? No! Knees to the back. Oh! And here comes Nora. Coming with a comeback. And she gets her up for a spine buster. And she goes for a cover. One, two, no! I can't believe what I'm seeing right here, ladies and gentlemen. These women are giving it all that they have for the HWA. Oh, and the combos. And Nora's starting to feel it. Trying to stay all over Roxy right now. And she goes outside of the ring, going under the apron. What she's got? She's got another guitar. And here she comes. Come on, Roxanne. Yes. Roxy was able to get away from the guitar shot. Oh! And a stomp outside of the ring, and she's hurt. Someone give her a mascara to fix all her mess. And she's going to the Iron Claw choke slam. You gotta believe there's gonna be implications after this matchup, ladies and gentlemen. There is no way that Roxanne will take this beating lightly. She's got her up. Power slam. And she's picking her back up. Throwing her into the ring. No, she won't grab anything. She's going straight for the jugular. Pulling her back for the curb stomps. Oh, and we got it now. Into the turnbuckle. Oh, reversal. Come on, Roxy. Yes, yes. Hitting her with the headbutts in the corner. And now with the stumps. And she's gonna go for a cover. One, two, no. This match is pretty much even, ladies and gentlemen. It could go either way at this point. And Roxanne's going for a table. Oh, no. No. Reversal. Come on, Roxanne. And she's choking her with the headbutt. Oh, she's calling her shot. She's getting her up. Off the top rope with a double axe hammer. And she's calling her shot. Oh, mandible claw. Will that be it? Double one, two, three, and it's over. And Roxanne has stolen my heart even more. The beautiful goddess queen Roxanne has become victorious in this matchup, taking all the damage from Nora Cool and making it into a victory. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Coming to the ring, Crystal Lake. Trying to be the next woman to become victorious here in the ring tonight. She has a very methodical entrance. She looks like she's bred for pain. Inflicting it, I might add. What a dark, dominant diva we have here. What are we going to see in this matchup? You got to think her tag team partner in Lance Blade is definitely going to be a dominant force in this matchup tonight. And here he comes to the ring. The man himself, Lance Blade. I've got to believe he's probably a striker. Other than the roundhouse kick. Matchups. The ladies are allowed to kick out the men, but the men have to just look at the women do their thing. Speaking of women, here comes the tag team individuals who will be meeting them in the ring tonight. In DDJ and Nightmare Shelly. I wonder who they hit with those things before they came out here. The S81 Rockers are coming to inflict pain. And they don't have any remorse in their faces right now. Looking to dominate. Have to have some animosity right now in this matchup, and they will be showing their stuff today. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, to start it off, it will be the ladies. Nightmare Shelly putting her down, face first, or face buster already. 1-2-0. One count only for Nightmare Shelly. And she throws her into the corner with a back flip and a spear to back it up in the corner. And she tags her partner in, and here comes the men. Oh! And he caught him right there. With the leg sweep running move. Coming off the ropes with the face wash. And a quick cover. 1-2-0. Currently was trying to do something there, but no. DDJ with the leg over the back of the head. And now with the rabbit punches, those piston-like punches to the temple, and now taking it to the side, methodically hitting the side of the face, and now pulling the arm. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, we know what comes next. Those knees to the back. And currently throwing him into the corner. Oh, reversal. Oh, into that face cracker. And he's now setting him up. Oh, he's got him in a figure four. Pulling the knees. And now, oh, a devil inside move from Lance Blade. DDJ not ready to give up yet. To the leg. And here we go. Rolling him over, lifting him up, slams him down. And now Lance Blade is in trouble, taking a big forearm to the face. And he looks like he's gonna get a second one for his trouble. Yet to see. Oh, oh my gosh. We've yet to. Oh, he's going up top over the ropes. Oh my God. For a cover. One. No. One count only. There's a lot of fight left in Lance yet. You're gonna have to do a lot more than that to Lance Blade to put him down. Oh, face plant to the ring mat. And he tags in Nightmare Shelley. Oh! And Crystal Lake takes the small advantage currently. Nightmare Shelley with a knee. Oh, and the men are outside of the ring. We got action outside. The men are still going at it, and oh, outside of the ring. Nightmare Shelley has taken out Crystal Lake, and now the repeated stomps outside of the ring, and we're going absolutely nuts here, ladies and gentlemen. No leg drop to the arm. And Nightmare Shelley throwing her down like a rag doll. Here we are. Oh, Crystal Lake able to counter out of that move. And she throws her into the barricade. And now the combos. Oh. But Shelley gets up. She was able to counter. Oh, she missed the big left. Oh, and catches a complete shot. Oh, these two women are going at it. Throw the face plant buster. And now she's getting her up. Oh, Shelley almost got her again, but Crystal Lake was able to grab her, throwing her into the ring. I told you, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, it's all about the ladies in this matchup. It depends on what they do. One count only. The women drive this match. They are a one-on-one matchup. Sling Blade. Oh, and she's got her up for the three kicks to the face. And here we are again. Oh, she's putting her up. Choke slam out of the mat. And she tags in her partner, and here comes the men. Oh. Lance Blade with the knee to the face after Crystal Lake had to recover. She got counted to a one count. If you don't know, that's an automatic disqualification if they last longer than the five count in the regular tag match. And now we got Lance Blade in full control. To the leg again. No, a third time won't happen. Here comes DDJ. Oh, and then punches to the gut with a right hook. And he's back in this matchup. And that knee to the back going into a front kick. And a choke slam off of the mat. And Lance Blade, oh, catching a mystifier to the face. And there's no count. There's no disqualification from the referee. Who's paying this gentleman? Oh, now into a crossface. He's got him in a crossface, and Lance is getting out. Sling Blade into a dropkick. Into the corner now. And he's wrenching on the arm on the ropes. Will he be able to use any of his acumen to get his partner in and get a little rest here? Oh, drop kick. Single leg drop kick there by Lance Blade. And he pulls him over for a monkey flip. Lance Blade up. He has him up and down. And going for a cover. One count only. And now Lance Blade giving him the sign that he's flipping over the top. And a connection. Lance Blade with a kick to the face. And now he's sending him across the ring area. And a big fist to the face. And Lance Storm stalking him. Lance Blade is taking carnage to the face of DDJ. And a reversal there. Oh, into the ring post. And Lance Blade is in trouble. And for the moment, he has a small advantage, but he takes time to taunt to the crowd to get a little motivation and gets reversed just for that trouble. Oh, a counter. And he's getting them up. Oh, unprettier outside of the ring. Throwing him back in, and Lance is stalking. Will he tag in his partner? He is gassed a little bit. And here comes the women. Oh, and a spin kick. Oh, Nightmare Shelley with the clotheslines. And she has been in complete control of the women's side of this matchup. Crystal Lake has had nothing thus far in a stunner. Crystal Lake getting her over. Going for the RKO. And Nightmare Shelley setting her up outside of the ring. What is she gonna do? Oh, she misses. She missed. Oh, and she has her. She's choking her with one hand. Nightmare Shelley was able to no-sell the miss. And she's choking her with one hand. And now setting her up for more stomp action. And a two, and a three, and a four, and a five, and six pack for your stomach. There isn't much that Crystal Lake has been able to do in this matchup. She did get that stunner off in a couple of reversals and going into a Billy Goat's curse. The one she pulls out. Sending her into the corner. Oh, and she's gonna give her a little hold down dance going into the wonderful sister, Abigail. Going for a cover. One count only. And Crystal Lake steps out of the ring and tags in Lance Blade. And here comes the men. And a quick cover pushing down the face. Two, three, and it's over. What the world happened there? Lance Blade had to be already gassed when he was coming into the ring and did not make the three count. And what do we have here coming up currently? It's Victor Venom coming to the ring. And he has, of course, the slippery snakes that he found in the grass this morning. This man keeps that away from this announcer. He's ready to rumble. What's gonna happen here, ladies and gentlemen, in this match? Who do we have coming to the ring? It will be his temporary tag team partner, Carl Green. Looking very methodically coming down to the ring with bat in hand. Yeah. And you gotta think that their partner that is yet to come out, Razor Parker. Gonna do everything that he can to annihilate the competitors, because I don't know a man that may want the title more than him. And here he comes. The maniacal maniac, Razor Parker. Chaos into the ring. He's ready to inflict his pain as advertised. And here come the three competitors that are looking to also get into the chamber match, the six-man chamber match at HWA Slaughterhouse. CJ Blade headed to the ring. And I'm sure that the ladies are just flocking to the side of the barricades just to get a look and a glimpse of his rippling chest. No way that this gentleman is anything less than an absolute Adonis. He's standing methodically, getting into the ring, slowly making his way. Apparently. I'm excited to see this match start. Let's get these two guys out here. And here comes everyone's favorite, Long Dog Johnson, who probably just finished a set backstage with three or four women in a jacuzzi. Oh, yeah. I wonder if he has any more energy to even fight in this match. You gotta believe he thinks he's God's gift to the world. He says it's in the name. Will this gentleman be able to get a victory with his tag team to be able to go to Slaughterhouse? And now, the last man to come out in this match is Hunter Hawkins. He's coming out no nonsense, ready to rumble. Yeah. than 1 moment. He's doing his thing, playing to the crowd, and already ready to fight. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, it's on now. And Viper's got his hands on Long Dong Johnson. I don't know if that's a good thing or not currently. He might not even be clean after his set he just left from backstage.
Johnson giving the Russian leg sweep. Oh, and there's a running powerbomb. Then I'm in trouble with CJ Blade. And Razor right there with a big power slam and an electric chair drop on top of the table. And I wish this announcer wishes that that table was already set. It would have been beautiful. There will be a lot of carnage in this match. Which team will be able to go to Slaughterhouse? No, into the stairs. And a belly to belly. And CJ Blade taking Carl Green, throwing them into the ring. And Hawkins is in the ring. And Carl Green starts stugging him and stubbing on the knees. And here he is going to the corner. No. Oh. He turns around and takes it out on CJ Blade. Going to, oh, leg DDT. Oh, clothesline from hell. Oh my God. What a kick there by CJ Blade, and he leads it off with combos afterwards. And CJ Blade up for the long ride from Razor Parker. Putting him up and putting him down. And a one count right there. And Long Don Johnson hitting him with the Russian leg sweep. Oh, neckbreaker. And Hulk is just raging right now. Oh, German suplex outside of the ring by CJ Blake. And oh, Venom misses a forearm off the top rope. And Hoggins with a reverse suplex in the center of the ring. Lawton Johnson had a trash can, but he thought better of it. Oh, and a floor kick shot up with a reversal by Razor Parker. And he's now in a reverse Hurricanrana. And they're counter there by Razor. And in the ring, we got Carl Green with an infant fury. So much action here, ladies and gents. Carl Green has Hawkins up in the ride. Go! And a face plant right there. Carl Green just chilling in the ring. And here comes Long Don Johnson. And CJ Blade has a guitar. Oh, powerbomb. And CJ Blade and Carl Green are currently going at it. And a big shoulder block. For a cover, no count. It broke the count pin there. Oh! Double misses on drop kicks there. And here we are. CJ Blade and Venom in the ring. And he's got him up. Brainbuster DDT from an inverted from another life. And two count only. Which tag team is going to be able to take this and go into Slaughterhouse to compete for the King of the Cage championship? Reversal right there on Carl Green, and he catches a knee to the face. And we got carnage all over the arena. And here comes Venom with a barbed wire bat, passing it out to both members laying in the center of the ring. Hawkins and CJ Blade both catching shots. Oh, big boot and a drop kick also. And Long Don Johnson is in trouble in a combo and is going for a three count. One, two, three, and it's over. And these three men will make it to Slaughterhouse for the King of the Cage championship. Venom, Carl Green, and Razor Parker. I'm sure there's going to be rivalry implications after this match, being that Long Don Johnson was probably only at half strength after his setback stage. And now comes the second matchup for the qualifier, for the King of the Cage. Here comes the big guy. Big City. Headed to the ring to make his claim for the position of being in the King of the Cage chamber match at Slaughterhouse. And here he
is these six men that are gonna be coming to the ring currently are all about this match. Every one of these 12 men were making a valid claim towards reaching the King of the Cage championship, but only six will make it. We've already seen the first three men. Let's find out who the other three will be. Who's next to come to the ring? And it will be that guy, Leo Maverick, coming to the ring, dropping mics. And now he's showing off money. Hey, someone go grab me some of that. This ring announcer doesn't get paid enough. And there's money coming from the top of the arena. Someone back, pass me a grab bag. I need all the money that I can get. Don't pay attention to me as I fill this bag up with money. Yeah, just keep letting that money fall down, buddy. I got about $200 or $300. Oh, there's a couple of hundreds now. And the crowd is enjoying at least that much from him. If everyone in HWA would come out with this entrance, I'd be a rich man. And look at him calling out his partner. They're ready to get it on. And here comes Marvy Empire. I'm sure these men have quite the rivalry and don't want to work together. But in order to make it the slaughterhouse, they're gonna have to push back all of the animosity and work as a well-oiled machine. And now these three men are in the ring. And let's see the next three competitors come down. And here comes the beer drinking brute. How is he even eligible for this matchup? One thing I'm going to say here, and believe me when I say this, I believe unequivocally and without question that Gunther Dobbins is absolutely hammered right now. He averages about 2.7 on the blood alcohol count on a daily basis. And we need to add an alcohol test before every one of his matchups. He would never make it. Look at him. He's so drunk, he doesn't even know where he is. Get in the ring. Oh my goodness. This is going to be a very interesting matchup. And if these three men do not pull out a victory, that it will be all on Gunther. And here comes Long Dong Johnson's cameraman. Sleazy has got to be awfully dirty right now. He may have even joined into that set backstage before this matchup. But Sleazy Dream headed to the ring regardless, and still looks like he's got a lot more sleaze left in him. This is a very sick and disgusting entrance, in my opinion. He's a horn dog ready for action. And now we wait for the last man to come in. Mr. Sander Cool. Look at the stars real high. Sander's racing up the sky. Can you feel the power? And he's doing his best impression of a very popular WWE superstar. Himself to get into the ring, saying he is the man that will help them win this tag team match. Let's see if he's able to actually pull that out, because we all know that Gunther is absolutely hammered. I wonder, will he be able to make it in this match? And we are getting it on. And look at Sleazy, as hairy and slimy as can be. We're gonna need to get disinfectant for the ring after this match. And here comes the kick from Cool. Thunder getting that arm wrench pulled back, and we all know what that's gonna be, the knees. Oh, but he has him set up in an abdominal pull right there in a submission hold. Oh, and Sleazy is getting his hands on him. Oh, and that big senton with the... I'm sure he's sweaty. I gotta laugh at his... I'm sorry. Sleazy is funny. That's got to be one of the most interesting wrestlers I've seen. And a cover on Sleazy by Big City. One count only. And here comes Dobbins. And Sleazy with the... with the Russian leg sweep, the reverse Russian leg sweep right there into a face plant and starts, and he busts them open. Oh, Dobbins with a knee. I apologize, I'm saying Dobbins and it should be Dobkins. Oh, and off the road. Oh no, it gets stopped by a glitch in the system. Oh! And Big City came up and hit him with, with a drop kick from behind. And Dobkins with the run, with the turnaround neck breaker. And Sleazy trying to throw his short stack at him. Oh, roll up into a super kick. And Dobkins thrown into the ring. And someone, oh! Takes a light bulb to the face, does Dobkins. And that stop sign that was being used on Sleazy was more than just literal. It was also metaphorical to stop the nastiness. But he's a nasty man. Pulling that dirty arm of Sleazy. I'm sure his hands are full of things that this ring announcer can't even imagine to say on air. And a reversal there by Cool. Oh, Sleazy with a reversal on the Big City. And Sleazy has him up. Oh, choked over the ropes. And he misses the big left hook right there and catches a kick to the gut. Oh, and he slaps him. The slap that tastes right out of his mouth, one count only. Which one of these two teams will be meeting the other competitors at Slaughterhouse? Oh! Nice suicide dive on Cartwheel over there. And Dobkins is in the ring with Big City all alone. And Sleazy's getting handled outside of the ring. And the knees to the back. Those two big men going at it in the ring. Can Dobkins even feel any of this? I know he's still feeling hell of a buzz. Throw to the clothesline. Going into a cover. One, two, no. And we're still going at it. Sleazy is getting destroyed out there while there's carnage in the ring. And Cool is throwing trash cans at his competitors. Oh, light bulb to the back of the head for a cover. Will that be it? One, two, no. And an elbow drop. There's light bulbs, trash cans, stop signs, and condoms somewhere out there, somewhere. Oh, reversal into a DDT by Dobkins. Oh, and a takedown with the palm hand strikes. Maverick's at a table. Oh, he misses the drop kick right there. Into a backdrop. Oh, these men, they got a lot coming. Oh! Face first into the trash can and a flip outside of the ring. Oh, double arm DDT. And Dobkins, will he be able to go to slaughterhouse? One, two, no. A break of the pin right at the last second. Dobkins almost got the slaughterhouse. And oh, the mandible claw. He's got him with the mandible claw. And then will he tap out? No. And you would think that Sleazy Dream might be able to. Oh my God, what a throw by Dobkins right there with the barbed wire bat. Oh! Sleazy Dream, will he be able to somehow make it to Slaughterhouse by sleazing his way out of this one? Oh my goodness. And the knees right there to the back of the knee. The slam to the knees and a cover by Dobkins. Will he win it? One, two, and he got a slow. Who's gonna take it? And Big City has him up in a cross. Oh, the big slam down from the Razor's Edge. One, two, the no. What happened there? Did the ref get hit by the roll-in? That should have been three. No one kicked out. And Sleazy doing his Sleazy shuffle. Into a rolling worm and going up elbow drop. And there's a two-way dance in the ring. One, two, three, and it's over. And somehow, some way, Gunther Dobkins Sleazy Dream and Sander Cool were able to come out of this alive. And the damn Sleazy Dream was able to slake and snake his way out of here and make it a slaughterhouse. And now, we've got a wonderful matchup coming up. Another Extreme Rules match between two gentlemen with a lot of moxie and animosity. Coming to the ring, just in case I don't make it home tonight, if you believe the moniker. Just in case I don't make it home tonight is like the first thing I think about when I hear that. And he will face Camp Doyle, and if he wins, he will be able to fight against Camp Doyle for the European Championship at Slaughterhouse. Will he be able to pull out a victory here and be able to challenge for the championship? That's one thing that this ring announcer would like to see. Will he be able to do it? What is gonna happen in this matchup right here? Here comes the champion. Cam Doyle is stalking to the ring. Will he be able to come on top of this matchup and be able to keep his title safe through the pay-per-view? There's only going to be one way to find out. He's gonna have to take care of business and take down that man in just in case. If he can take him down, he doesn't have to worry about him for the pay-per-view. Just in case is ready. And so is Cam Doyle, and let's get it on. Just in case is a huge competitor. And he went for a quick cover right there. Of course, it was a one count. Oh, and what a German suplex to flip over his competitor. And Cam Doyle with the combos. And he's going for a cover. One, two, no. Oh, he's going into a flip power bomb outside of the ring.
And Cam Doyle has the advantage. And Justin Case has him up and a slam into the apron. He's gotta be very careful here. Justin has him up. Oh, and Doyle was able to reverse. Oh, and he throws him. And he picks him up in a reverse suplex outside of the ring onto the floor. What is going to happen here, ladies and gents? This is a hell of a matchup. And I'm going to get my popcorn ready. This seems like something that is very interesting. Only a one count there by Doyle. And he slams his face into the mat repeatedly. And then again, from behind with the hits to the back of the head on the mat. And oh, a knee. And there he is, taunting his opponent. Picking him up. And a drop kick from a springboard, and he goes for a quick cover. Will he be able to win or get a slaughterhouse two count only? And there he is, he's setting him up, putting the arm down in a stomp. One, two, no. Oh, these two men, giving everything that they have to be able to compete in this matchup. Suplex. Oh. And he's raging. Going under the ring for something under the apron. He's pulling out a table. Oh, to the face. And he throws it down at him. And Doyle is in trouble. Oh, to the barricade. And just in case with the monkey flip. And he mounts him, starting to beat his face in. And that is one hell of a big guy. And he is currently all over Doyle. And he's pulling them into the ring again. And here he is, stalking his prey. Oh, he misses the Superman punch. And Doyle has him back down, coming off the ropes with a fist to the face. And now a springboard clothesline. And Justin Case is getting all he can handle from Chris Doyle. And Cam Doyle now has the advantage. He pulls him out. But Justin Case is still getting up. He's a hell of a man to have to take down for his size. And he goes for a cover. One, two, oh. What is going to happen between these two gentlemen? Cam Doyle standing in the ring trying to go after, oh my God, with the bat. Doyle again. And Doyle was able to, oh! He caught another shot to the face, and he hits him with a one-legged drop kick. Both men wanting to win this matchup. I would think that Cam Doyle really wants to win this more. It has title opportunities ahead of behind it if he does. And Doyle throws the big man. Will he be able to win it? Oh, into a reverse Russian leg sweep, face plant on the ring floor. Justin Cage with the flip over. And he has him still. And he flips him again. And now Doyle is in trouble. Guitar shot from a throw by Justin Case. And a knee to the face. And now, Cam Doyle is in trouble. He is thrown into the ring. What in the world is going to happen in this matchup? Oh, big powerbomb. For cover, one, two, no, two count only. He has it up. Oh, TKO. For a cover. One, two, no. What has he got to do to take down this big man? And a stomp to the knee. And he grabs the trash can out. And just in case, he has him in an arm bar from the triangle. Will he tap out? Is he gonna submit? No. And now, Doyle with the reversal. And he throws him into the corner with a knee. And he looks like he's setting him up for something, but no, a reversal and a Superman punch. And now goes into a cover. One, two, three, and it's over. Justin Case wins this matchup and keeps his end of the bargain. And now, Cam Doyle has to put his title on the line at Slaughterhouse. But we're going to go to the main event. The champion versus champion match between that man coming to the ring, King Dominator, and El Jefe. The current television champion for the HWA. a rendition of an old school WCW belt. What a beautiful, beautiful title. What will these two men do here in this matchup? This is gonna be a good one to see. And now, coming to the ring.
I apologize if I got his name wrong.
I may have done that. No, I did not. Yes, here comes the Mayhem World Champion in El Jefe. The Mayhem World Champion coming to the ring. Two men that are two of the top contenders in this HWA era. Putting their manhood on the line. This has not anything to do with titles tonight. It only has to do with being the better man. No one is going to be losing their titles tonight, but there will be one man standing above the other and holding bragging rights at the end of this matchup. And El Jefe trying to take the fast advantage, throwing King Dominator out of the ring. Throwing a kick to the knee or a drop kick by the Dominator. And a knee to the shoulder and the arm area by the King Dominator on El Jefe. And the rapid fire punches to follow them up. And now he's gonna mount him. And he starts beating on him like a rabid piece of meat. And he goes for a quick pin cover. One, two, no. No, cutter off of the springboard. And El Jefe is in trouble early. And he reverses. He comes up. He's grabbing a knee and he drops the knee down. And again, and he goes for a cover. One count only, and there is a lot more fight in this match with a crossbody. And he goes and he stumps down on him, pressing on the chest, hurting his rib cage area, trying to affect King Dominator's breathing and trying to take down his stamina. And now here we are with the combos into a knee, into a back axe kick. And now here comes Dominator going up to the ring. He got a stop sign. No drop kick. And El Jefe has the stop sign. Oh, to the face. And he goes for a pin cover. One. Two, no. Two count only on that count. And a rake to the face. Oh, he was trying to go to a springboard and got caught up. And setting him up for a spinning European uppercut. And he's back on top of this match. And pressing back again on the chest area. misses. And he's going for a cover. One, two, no. Two count. You got to think there's a lot more left in these gentlemen. He's grabbed the nose and slapped him. And a spin kick. And now going for the curb stomps from behind. And a stomp down. Oh! A step to the shoulder to try to cause damage with a stomp. So no, he misses. No kick to the dead knee to the face. And he picking up El Jefe like an old tamale. Cody Cutter on a springboard one more time. Oh, and he has the ankle. He's going for the ankle lock. He's going for the ankle lock. Will he give up? No, he rolls out. Oh, and what a clothesline. And here he is. Oh, double stomp to the arm. El Jefe is not out just yet. And Willie has him up. And he's going for the three suplexes. The desk number two. Will he complete the third? Yes. And he goes for the cover. One, two, no. The three amigos did not work that time. But El Jefe is still in control. He got a guitar. Stalking him, looking for his position. No, he misses. Into the ropes. Under, over, spear. Will that be it, ladies and gentlemen? He's down for the count. One, two, no. And here we are. These two men were refusing to give up. And a pile driver. And another cover. One, two, three, and it's over. And oh my God, El Jefe goes down. The heavyweight, well, the world champion goes down to the world dominator. That has got to have future title opportunities coming to King Dominator after that win. If he's the champion, how did he lose to the television champ? What's gonna happen next week on HWA?